So the third topic I want to discuss is scaling up graph neural networks by simplifying their architecture. And this is kind of an orthogonal approach to the first two approaches. And here is how we are going to do this. We will start from a graph convolutional network, just as an example architecture, and we are going to simplify it by removing the nonlinear activation from the GCN. Right? And actually there's been a paper 2 years ago or a year and a half ago that demonstrates that the performance on benchmarks is not too much lower because you have removed the nonlinearity. And this means that now this simplified GCN architecture turns out to be an extremely scalable model that we can train very fast. So basically the idea here is you are going to simplify the expressive power of the graph neural network so that you can train it faster. Of course, this kind of defeats the purpose of deep learning a bit because the point of deep learning or representation learning is a lot of data over, over complex models that can model complex representations. Here we are saying simplify the model so it's fast to run on big data. And of course, there is a trade-off there. So let me introduce the GCN and then we'll continue from there, right? So GCN takes in a graph with node features, and let's assume that every node includes a self loop. This will be convenient for mathematical notation later. And let's think of this as a full batch implementation, right? So we basically set the node embeddings at layer zero to be simply node features, and then we are going to iterate for k layers, where at every node at layer k plus one is going to take the embeddings of its neighbors from the previous layer, sum them up, divide by the number of layers, number of neighbors transformed by this learned matrix, and pass through a nonlinearity. And then we are going to run this recursion for k iterations, and whatever we end up in the end with, whatever embedding we end up at the end, that is what we call final embedding. Now, what is benefit of GCN is that it is so simple, we can very nicely write it into the in the matrix form. So the way we are going to write it in the matrix form is that we are going to take these embeddings and we are going to stack them into an embedding matrix. And then A is our adjacency matrix where every node also has a self loop. Then the way you can write the sum over the neighbors of a given node, some of the embeddings of the neighbors of a given node, you can simply write this as a product between the adjacency matrix A and the embedding matrix H. What this means is that now we can also define this notion of D to be a diagonal matrix, where it is all of zero, only on the diagonal we have the degree of every node. And then the inverse of D, D to the minus one, is the inverse of the diagonal matrix, which is just you put one over the degree on the diagonal entry for every node. So now the way you can write a summation over the neighbors divided by the degree of that node is simply the inverse of the diagonal matrix, so one over the degree, times the adjacency matrix A, times the hidden embeddings matrix H. So this means that now given H at level L, if we multiply it by A and multiply it by D to the minus one, we get the matrix of node embeddings at level H plus one. So basically what is elegant here is that you can rewrite this iteration just as a product of three matrices. And of course, in the GCN, we also have a ReLU nonlinearity and transformation here. So going back to the GCN, here is the node-based formulation of the GCN. If you write it in the matrix form, you can write it that this is a nonlinearity times this A tilde that is simply degree times A, times the previous layer embeddings, times the W matrix, which is the transformation matrix. So basically the equation, this equation that is based on the network and the following matrix equation, they are equivalent. So if you compute this product of these matrices, you have just computed the k plus 1 layer embedding for all the nodes of the network. And now you can kind of iterate this capital K times to compute the k layers. So this is what a matrix formulation of a GCN looks like. So let's now go and simplify the GCN. Let's assume and go and remove this ReLU nonlinearity. So let's say, what would happen if the GCN would be governed by the following equation, right? So going back, this is the equation with the nonlinearity. Now we decided to drop the nonlinearity. So here is our, you know, simplified GCN equation. So now let's go and unroll this this iteration. Let's unroll this recursion, right? So we say, here is the final layer embeddings for the nodes. They depend on the layer k minus 1 embeddings of the nodes. So let's now take this h to the k minus 1 and insert it with the way we compute h to the k to the minus h at the layer k minus 1. And you know, I take this part and just I insert it here. And now I notice this depends on hk minus 2. So again, I can go take hk minus 2 and again expand it. And if I do this all the way down to the zero layer, then I know what to do, right? Like h0 is simply the vector of node features x. These a tildes just kind of get multiplied together. So this is a tilde raised to the power k. And this here at the end, this parameter matrices, it is just a product of parameter matrices that is still a matrix. So I can rewrite this recursive equation if I expand it in the following way. And then I realize that a product of parameter matrices is just a parameter matrix, right? So basically, I have just rewritten the k-layer GCN into this very simple equation that is non-recursive. It's a tilde raised to the power k times the feature vector times the transformation matrix. So what is important? What do you need to remember here about a tilde raised to the power k? Remember in, I think, lecture 1 or 2, we talked about what does powering the adjacency matrix to the kth power mean? It means we are counting paths. It means we are connecting nodes that are neighbors of neighbors and so on. So basically what this means is that this a tilde to the k really connects the target node to its neighbors, neighbors of neighbors, neighbors of neighbors of neighbors, and so on, one hop farther out in the network as we increase k. And that's very interesting. So now, what can we conclude? We can conclude that removing the nonlinearity significantly simplifies the GCN. Notice also that this a tilde to the k times x does not include contain any learnable parameters, so we can actually pre-compute this on the CPU even before we start training, right? And this can be very efficiently computed because all I have to do is multiply the a tilde with x kind of with itself multiple times, and I will be able to get to the a tilde raised to the power k times x. So computing this part is very easy. It does not depend on any model parameters, so I can just pre-compute it even before I start learning. So now, so what we have learned is that this a to the k times x can be pre-computed, and let's call this x tilde. So now the simplified GCN, the final embedding layer, is simply this x tilde times the parameter matrix. And this is just a linear transformation of the pre-computed matrix, right? So the way I can think of this, this is basically just a pre-computed feature vector for node v times its times the matrix learned matrix w. So embedding of node v only depends on its own pre-processed features, right? Where I say this x tilde is really x tilde computed by a tilde raised to the power k times x, right? But this is a matrix that has one row for every node. So if I say what is the final layer embedding of a given node, is simply the corresponding row in the matrix times the learned parameter matrix w. But what is important to notice here is that once this x tilde has been computed, then the embedding of a given node only depends on a given row of the x tilde that is fixed and constant. And the only thing that changes that is learnable is w. So what this means is that embeddings of m nodes can be generated in linear time linear with m, because for a given node, its final embedding only depends on its own row in the matrix x tilde. So I can easily sample a mini batch of nodes. I sample a set of rows from the matrix x, and then I multiply that with w to get the final layer embeddings of those nodes in the mini batch. So, and of course this will be super fast because there is no dependencies between the nodes, or all the dependencies are already captured in this matrix x tilde. So in summary, simplified GCN consists of two steps: the pre-processing step, where we pre-compute this x tilde to be simply the adjacency matrix A with 1 over the degree of the node on the diagonal. We call this A tilde. We raise this to the kth power, so we multiply it with itself k times, and then we multiply this with the original features of the nodes x. And all this can be done on a CPU even before we start training. So now what this means is that we have this matrix x tilde that has one row for every node, and that's all we need for the training step, where basically for each mini batch we are going to sample m nodes at random, and then we simply compute their embeddings by taking w and multiplying it with the corresponding entry in the matrix x tilde that corresponds to that node v. And we simply compute the final layer embeddings of all the nodes in the mini batch. And then, you know, we can use these embeddings to make predictions, compute the loss, and then update the matrix, the parameter matrix w. So the good point here is that now the embedding of every node, computation of it, it's independent from the other nodes. It is a simple matrix times vector product, where the matrix W is what we are trying to learn, and this can be done super, super fast. So now let's summarize and kind of compare cluster GCN with other methods we have learned today. The simplified GCN generates node embeddings much more efficiently. There is no need to create the giant computation graph. There is no need to do graph sampling. It is all very, very simple, right? You just do those matrix products, and then the learning step is also very easy. So it seems great, but what do we lose? Right, compared to cluster GCN, mini batch of nodes in a simplified GCN can be sampled completely at random from the entire set of nodes. As I said, there is no need to do node groups, to do the like in cluster GCN, no need to do the induced subgraph, nothing like this. So this means that the training is very stable, and the variance of the gradients is much more under control. But right, what is the price? The price is that this model is far, far less expressive. Meaning, compared to the original graph neural network models, simplified GCN is far less expressive because it doesn't have the nonlinearity in generating node embeddings. So it means that the theory that we discussed about computation graphs, Weisfeiler-Lehmann isomorphism test, keeping the structure of the underlying subgraphs through that injective mapping, all that is out of the window because we don't have the nonlinearity anymore. So that really makes a huge difference in the expressive power of the model, right? But, you know, in many real world cases, simplified GCN tends to work well and tends to kind of work just slightly worse than the original graph neural networks, even though being far less expressive in theory. So the question is, why is that? And the reason for that is something that is called graph homophily, which basically means this is a concept from social science. Generally, people like to call it birds of feather stick together. So, or birds of feather flock together. So basically, the idea is that similar people tend to connect with each other, right? So that basically, you know, computer scientists know each other. People who study music know each other. So essentially, the idea is that you have these social communities that are tightly compact, where people share properties and attributes. Just because it is easier to connect to people who have something in common with you, with whom you share some interest, right? So basically, what this means in, let's say, networks, both in social, biological, knowledge graphs, is that nodes connected by edges tend to share the same labels, they tend to have similar features. Right, in citation networks, papers from the same area tend to cite each other. In movie recommendation, it's like people are interested in given genres and you watch multiple movies from the same genre. So these movies are kind of similar to each other. So, and you know, why is this important for a simplified GCN? Because the three pre-processing step of a simplified GCN is simply feature aggregation over a k-hop neighborhood, right? So the pre-processing features are obtained by iteratively averaging features of the neighbors and features of the neighbors of neighbors without learned transformation and without any nonlinearity. So as a result, nodes connected by edges tend to have similar pre-processing features. And now if labels are also clustered kind of across the homophilous parts of the network, if the labels kind of cluster across the network, then simplified GCN will work really well. So basically, when does the simplified GCN works? The premise is that the model uses the pre-processed node features to make prediction. Nodes connected by edges tend to get similar pre-processed features because it's all about feature averaging across local neighborhoods. So if nodes connected by edges tend to be in the same class, tend to have the same label, then simplified GCN is going to make very accurate predictions. So basically, if the graph has this kind of homophily structure. Now, if the graph doesn't have this homophily structure, then the simplified GCN is going to fail quite badly. So that's kind of the intuition. And of course, ahead of time, we generally don't know whether labels are clustered together or they're kind of sparkled across the network. So to summarize, simplified GCN removes nonlinearity in GCN and then reduces to simple pre-processing of the node features and graph adjacency matrix. When these pre-processed features are obtained on the CPU, a very scalable, simple mini-batch stochastic gradient descent can be directly applied to optimize the parameters. Simplified GCN works surprisingly well in many benchmarks. The reason for that being is that those benchmarks are easy. Nodes of similar label tend to link to each other. They tend to be part of the same network, and meaning that just simple averaging of their features without any nonlinearities and without any different weighing of them gives you a good performance in practice.